and I say this with love and compassion, I encourage white people to become courageous. See, we need some more courageous white people. And we're actually seeing that with the young people who are marching across the country. So this is a moment that we have to pay attention to, right? I was reading a study, and it's fascinating. It's fascinating. If you think about change, and this is a change moment time, everybody knows about the Titanic, right? The Titanic, the RMS Titanic, it, I think in 1912, it was like the Lamborghini of boats, sailing from the UK to New York City. We all know it hit an iceberg and it sunk. Only 700 of the 2,200 folks aboard lived. They had half of the amount of boats that they needed to survive. Why is this important? This is a story that's important for us all. But as we start talking about really integrating other viewpoints in our, because this is a crisis moment, in a crisis moment, right? So there is a viewpoint that said, why did they look at the iceberg as the problem? 65 years prior, a boat with the same situation pulled alongside the iceberg and let people get off the ship to live. But guess what didn't happen in the RMS Titanic? They were more concerned about letting the elite first class in the boats versus trying to get a diversity of viewpoint, because they had about an hour while it was still operational. Wow. Why didn't they figure out, some of those engineers who were in the basement in sewage, to say, we got this problem. Can you help us solve it? But they were more concerned about getting Guggenheim. Now let's talk, people. Let's talk to one another. Getting Guggenheim off of first class in a boat than saving everybody. We have to be able to be real with one another. Mm-hmm. If you look at a problem as just a problem that is my problem and my problem alone, you'll have the same market share, you'll have the same situation, you'll have the same, it's called sort of the vanguard of being functionally stagnant. You'll have the same viewpoint. Mm-hmm. If you can't imagine that people get in the back of a stranger's car, we'd never have Uber. Right? So if you look at things in stagnation, you'll stay there. We have to be our own change agents. We have to start being our own change agents. And the only way you can do that is to add a diversity of viewpoints. Mm-hmm. Isn't that lovely? That's lovely. But first you have to start with, I need to change. My organization needs to change. My viewpoint needs to change. So first you have to start by integrating change agency into your vocabulary.
What does that even sound like?
Something's wrong. If you can look at a television set and know that you sit in a place of privilege, and 40 million people through a pandemic are out of work, but I sit over here and I'm okay, and not involve a change agency viewpoint. Whether you know it or not, the world has turned upside down. We have 40 million Americans alone, and we're in a global pandemic. Americans alone. So everything from supply chain, every institution has been impacted. I don't know all the agencies and industries that you have represented here today, Matt Gaines, but every industry has been impacted by the pandemic. My son, who's 14, he said, well, the pandemic didn't beat racism. Pandemic got 2 stars. Racism got 4 stars, meaning that the time period is lending itself to realizing that unless and until we devolve the institutions that guide our commerce, our industry, how our communities connect with one another. And this is our change agency time. And the good news is the folks here on your call, the Mad Gains crew, they are the real agents of change.
They are.
But first you have to, you gotta feel it.
We're disruptors, that's for sure.
You're disruptors. And disruptors disrupt. Disruptors disrupt. And it's now their time to disrupt. And first and foremost, they have to believe that they can pull the boat up to a new iceberg and make it and make something happen out of it. There's some lemonade that's about to happen, but are your change agents going to be part of the folks pulling up and letting the other folks live? Now think about anyone that had just gone downstairs instead of trying to lock them out. That has said, we have this problem. Can you help us fix it? See, to me right now, we need all hands on deck. But first you have to identify change as the issue. We have to change our mindsets. We have to change our institutional biases. We have to change how we view diversity and inclusion. It's actually a value add to every organization.
I can tell you that, first of all, every word you're saying is giving me chills, I want you to know. And I can see in all the comments on social media that are lighting up, people are just hearing you. The first thing, I've been on an executive leadership position at many different companies, as have you, Christy, and as is JD and has been. The first thing I thought of when you spoke was I thought about all the executive meetings we would have, and it was the same group. We all looked kind of the same too, but it was the same group over and over again. And I can imagine if I had heard your words 2 years ago or 4 years ago, I probably would have popped my head up and looked around the room and rethought who's always sitting in this same room. It almost as if these executives were my team and they formed a bubble around me.
Mm-hmm.
And shielded me from what was really going on. And a lot of us who have been employees in different positions and not executives, we've actually seen this happen where we're screaming from the bottom saying this ship is heading toward a big, huge, giant glacier and the executives have the CEO in a bubble.
Yeah.
So he or she doesn't hear it.
Because they're protecting what they consider as their sort of livelihood, right? So the protection at the top, like a pyramid, seeks to protect and bubble and isolate that point of view because that benefits them. You know, they talk about it in a pyramid for a reason where the folks in the middle and the folks on the bottom never get a chance to see what really is occurring there in that bubble. But the bubble isn't real. See, the bubble, what we've done right now is we've pierced the bubble at the top in terms of the credibility of all these systems. What the pandemic did for all of us was lay bare how vulnerable all of our systems are,
so
right?
True.
So in terms of supply chain, we had people fighting each other for toilet paper because they have no idea how they get toilet paper. Right? We have people fighting each other for chicken and steak because they don't understand how all that is sourced. So, bringing it back.